Let's start today's class. We were studying about photosynthesis, and in the chapter photosynthesis we were discussing about the mechanism of photosynthesis. We have already learned that photosynthesis involves two different phases. The first phase is a light reaction and the second phase is a dark reaction. Light reaction is carried out in the presence of sunlight, whereas dark reaction does not require any sunlight. So that is why it is also called as light independent phase or biosynthetic phase, as I have already explained to you, because during this phase carbon dioxide is fixed, is converted into glucose, that is glucose food molecule is produced. Now first thing which you need to remember here is that the occurrence of dark reaction, where does the light dark reaction occur? Inside the chloroplast. So if you are asked about the site of dark reaction, you should say stroma. Light reaction occurs in thalamoid, whereas this dark reaction occurs in the stroma. In higher classes, when you go the dark reaction in a very complicated manner, you will be learning, there you will be learning about Calvin cycle. This dark reaction involves several steps. Okay, in detail you will be learning in class 11. Okay, where you will learn this dark reaction in the form of Calvin reaction, C3 pathway, C4 pathway, Hanselet pathway, okay, which is not required here in class 10. In a very simple manner, we are supposed to learn this dark reaction. So if we are asked to define dark reaction, we can define dark reaction by saying that it is a phase of photosynthesis during which carbon dioxide is fixed or converted into glucose molecule by utilizing the ATP molecule or the energy of ATP molecule and the reducing power of NADPH to produce glucose molecule. Okay, so this is how you can define dark reaction. And then as the product of, if we ask about the product of dark reaction, here the product of dark reaction is glucose molecule. This glucose molecule immediately get converted into starch molecule by the process called polymerization. Polymerization means, in polymerization what happens is, in polymerization the smaller unit like glucose keeps on linking with each other and form a long chain to form the molecule of starch. Okay, so starch is polymer, whereas glucose is monomer, which is the smaller unit. So this is about the dark reaction. Now the next topic which we need to learn is opening and closing of stomata. Opening and closing of stomata. Before going into this topic, first we must understand about the stomata. Okay, what are stomata? If you are asked, what do you say? So stomata are the minute openings present on the surface of leaf, which helps in the exchange of gases and water vapor, you can say, as it happens in case of transpiration. So minute pores present on the surface of leaf, but which helps in the exchange of gases. And then if you see the structure of the stomata remains surrounded by the cells which are called subsidiary cells. And then it consists of two kidney-shaped cells which are called guard cells. Okay, so if you are asked about what are guard cells, the two kidney-shaped cells which encloses the pore, which we call as the stoma, is what we call the guard cells. These guard cells are responsible for regulating the opening and closing of stoma. Okay, whether the stoma will open or close. Now guard cells, the outer wall of the guard cell is thinner, whereas the inner wall of guard cell is thicker. Okay, now one more important point which I would like to include here is that guard cells are assumes different shapes in isobilateral and dorsiventral leaf. That is, in dicot leaf, these guard cells are usually kidney shaped or any remiform shaped. Okay, to be more correct, we can say remiform cell, biologically correct. Now see, and in case of monocot plants, These guard cells are dumbbell cell. Dumbbell cell means they would be like bone like structures. Bone like structure, dumbbell cell or dumbbell like structure. Dumbbell cell. In monocotyledon, the guard cells are dumbbell cell, whereas in case of dicotyledon, it is kidney cell. So inside the guard cell, we can see here I have labeled chloroplast also, nucleus. Okay. So this is about the structure of stomata. Now comes the theory which regulates the theory which explains the opening and closing mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. Okay. Now here in the book two theories are mentioned: sugar ion concentration theory and then potassium ion concentration theory. Sugar ion concentration theory is not in the syllabus. Only potassium ion concentration theory we are supposed to learn in class 10. Potassium ion concentration, let me explain to you what is how to explain this potassium ion concentration theory, or how potassium ion concentration theory explains the opening and closing of the stomata. Now what happens is that during the daytime, the guard cells perform photosynthesis as they bear chloroplast, and as a result, ATP molecules are produced. These ATP molecules are utilized in pumping the potassium ion into the guard cell, from the surrounding. Okay, during the daytime. Now, as the potassium ion enters into the guard cell, the osmotic pressure or the concentration inside the guard cell increases. As the concentration inside the guard cell increases, the water molecule from the surrounding, by the process of osmosis or endosmosis, okay, enters into the guard cell. As a result, the guard cell swells up, becomes turgid, the outer wall becomes more convex, and the inner wall starts moving apart from each other, resulting in opening of stomata. So this is how the stomata opens, okay, as per potassium ion concentration theory. Then after that comes closing of stomata. Now during the night time, the potassium ion which are present inside the guard cells diffuses to the surrounding. As it diffuses to the surrounding, the concentration inside the guard cell decreases, and due to this reason, whatever the water that is present inside the guard cell moves to the surrounding by the process of exosmosis. Okay, then as the guard cell loses the water, it becomes flaccid, the outer wall gets shrink, and the inner wall move closer to each other, resulting in closing of stomata. So this is how we can understand how the opening and closing of stomata is regulated, okay, in plants. So this is about the mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. Now after this topic, we'll discuss about external and internal factors affecting the rate of photosynthesis. Thank you.